My Instagram live. Today's topic is marketing in a recession. For all of you who are new to my page, my name is again Makita Waterman. I am the CEO of Top Writing Services Incorporated. For the past 6 years, I've been working contractually or at home from my laptop or sometimes even in clients' offices if they are close by, helping them solve marketing problems and creating content and a strategy that helps them get from either low-level sales or medium-level sales to exactly reaching their financial goals. So today I wanted to chat a little bit about how you can go about using easy-to-apply tips and advice to improve the way that you run your business. Aside from that, I just wanted to say that I've been going live here on Instagram for the past several months. If you missed any of my lives where I talked about branding, content marketing, business writing, social media, TikTok, LinkedIn, etc., check out my YouTube channel. There's a whole lot of more content that's in-depth and much more detailed than I share here on Instagram. So the first thing that I want to start off with is having a mindset for marketing, whether you're doing this by yourself or you're about to train employees. You really have to be in the mindset in knowing that in today's business market, consumers, or which is a fancy word for people that are looking to buy things, are actually living on apps that include YouTube, Twitter, and Instagram, making purchasing decisions, and not quick purchasing decisions, but following us and watching our content and seeing if there's anything that resonates or sits well with them to make them realize that we are the experts. We are the company that can solve their business development or their career or finance or relationship problems, etc. You have to develop your mind to get ready for this new world. It is changing so quickly. Marketing around this time last year, a company could literally just have nothing but stock photos on their page and get customers. But now, or an influencer could literally avoid, hi, thanks so much for joining. An influencer could literally avoid answering comments or responding to their messages and get brand deals. But now we're living in a day where companies and people that want to buy from us, they really want to see that we have their best interest in mind. And the only way that we can continue to show them that is by developing either a thick skin, which means if you're seeing a trolling comment, you know, kind of brushing it off and moving on with your day, or having the confidence to really be more than just the stock images on our photos or just kind of going live once a month and hoping that that will wing it on apps that are so oversaturated with competition like here on Instagram. So other than building your mindset, you want to definitely have a strategy and a marketing calendar that shows you the time of the days that you're going to post, the days of the week you're going to post, topics that you're going to post, and even if it's easier for you, create a campaign of specific topics that you're going to focus on social media so that you don't have to constantly be checking Google or Google Trends, for example, to find keywords and figure out what you're going to do next. I film about 6 videos during the week when I take a walk or when I have some free time during my day. And then I know at the end of the day, I don't have to, you know, run home after a business meeting or meeting friends and family and film a video every night like I did when I first started. Other things that you can commit yourself to do is actually having either an online or a physical schedule, which tells you what topics you're going to share and the days that you're going to share them and whether you're going to do videos, infographics, selfies with, of course, a business component or some kind of educational content in the caption. Or if you're going to choose to maybe go live and talk about a series of different topics, again, to solve people's problems or entertain them. And that's the mindset of marketing that successful companies get into, is they literally have a schedule. They literally meet every week and talk to their entire team, sometimes with executives or not, and they have specific conversations about the topics that were working, the topics that are working, how they're going to go about conveying that message and doing it in a way that is comfortable for consumers and strangers that come to their website or read their blog or visit their Instagram page, etc. So really get into the mindset of a strategy. I used to be one of those people a year and a half ago where I'd literally wake up and figure out what I was going to post. I didn't have a strategy. I wasn't testing topics. I was just kind of winging it on Instagram, wondering why my following was sitting at about 200, 300 something followers, and not realizing that nothing that I was sharing or most of what I was sharing on Instagram wasn't scheduled. It wasn't thought of with a process and a strategy and a branding and a marketing way of doing things. So that's what I can definitely say with that. In addition to having an actual strategy and figuring things out as the days go by, you want to stay up to par with the local trends in your area or with industrial trends that are happening in your particular industry, whether you're in fashion, beauty, you're in marketing, sales, oil and gas, etc. And you want to always be 10 steps ahead of the curve than the industry by creating your own topics, scanning the internet and seeing what people are not talking about, and being more than willing and happy to share it yourself, because you know that you'll be the first, you know, company in the industry talking about it. And if the content is full of quality, full of advice, and something that's going to really catch the attentions of your competitors or bloggers in your industry, for example, then you just started a trend. And that's what I try to do each and every day when I show up on every social media app, is not so much look at what everybody else is doing, because I want to be original. I do my best to set my own trends. And if it doesn't turn into a trend at the end of the day or at the end of the week, at least I know that somebody's listening or reading and is going to take that information and use it to their best of ability, or ask me additional questions in the messages, etc. Other than some of the pinpoint things that I had mentioned, I can definitely say on Instagram what I do see a lot of is nothing but photos. And I suppose that's okay, but the people that spend a lot of time on apps like Triller or TikTok or even Twitter, these people generally are so used to seeing quick content, high quality content, or really, really content that is has high production, so to say, as far as the effects are concerned. So when I now come here on Instagram and I see a lot of photos, and it's always great when I see videos too, but a lot of photos, actually mentally I kind of pause and I want to get out of the app, because photos don't speak to my heart. Photos don't speak to my mind. They don't speak to me as far as come into my store and buy from me or click on my website and check me out. And so if there's anything that I can leave with this live today, I would definitely tell you that video has always been the biggest platform for people like myself. I can say for myself, business has increased because of the constant and daily generation of videos that I keep sharing. And it's hard for some people to even think about doing that, let alone creating their own designs without having to stand in front of a video, because it creates some hesitation. But the best thing that I can say is, like I said in one of my recent TikTok videos that I shared here on Reels, talk as if you're speaking to your best friend. And instead of focusing so much on what are they going to think about my hair or how I look or the outfit that I'm wearing, I would definitely say that the best thing that you can do is think more about the quality of your message, what you're sharing, and how you're sharing it, more than the aesthetics of the colors of the room or the colors of your outfit. And of course, these are things that you definitely want to think about too. But I can definitely sit here and say that if there's anything that you want to learn today from video marketing, you have to answer frequently asked questions that people are thinking in their mind when they come on your website, they read your blog, they see your profile for the first time, because I always like to say this, your content should be speaking volumes for you while you're sleeping at 1 o'clock in the morning. Your content should be answering frequently asked questions so that you can reduce time that you're spending picking up phone calls and sending emails. And I'm not saying that you should become like a diva or, evasive and avoid phone calls and emails. But if your content is so high quality and jam-packed of the 5 W's, who, what, where, when, and why, or even how, you don't have to spend that much time communicating with people. That time could be spent training your employees or doing road trips for business development or studying or working on projects or hiring people. So I truly hope that this marketing in the time of a recession helps you. I am committed to continuing to show up live Monday through Friday until September 22nd. A quick update, after September 22nd, I will only be going live twice a week, and that will be on Mondays and Fridays. The way I'll be doing it is on Mondays, it will be a topic that has been chosen by each and every one of you that participate in my Instagram poll stories. But then on Fridays, it will be like an open conversation for each and every one of you to ask me questions based on content that I've been sharing here on Instagram before Friday or prior to that, etc. So I do want to thank you so much for tuning in. I'm truly, truly blessed to have an audience like you. I love getting in front of a camera and really sharing general advice. And of course, some of you might be watching this saying, how is this going to help me? I am a consultant, so I don't know what your situation is, but I am giving out general advice because sometimes it's just the little things that make a big difference. And so if you're new to my page and you're watching this, click the follow button. If anybody that's watching this has any questions, let me know in the direct messages. I'll do my best to answer questions that you have. And I have some more business development, kind of like COVID-19 era recession-proof topics coming through. It matters to me that whatever I put out is helping each and every one of you. And I'm glad to switch it up because, doing the same thing over and over again can kind of get mundane and a little boring. So I'll definitely switch it up. I'm just thinking if there's anything else that I have to share right now before I go. So I'm going to be uploading this if you're watching this, and I am going to be putting this on my YouTube channel. All my long videos, IGTV chats, will be on my YouTube channel. So click link in bio if you want to check that out. And at least once a week, I'll share an Instagram live so that each and every one of you can kind of get a sense of what I'm up to when I go live here on Instagram. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you have a wonderful evening. And again, tomorrow I'll be here. Tomorrow's topic will be, I'm going to talk about video marketing since I promote it so much and since a lot of people are unsure about how to go about doing the best videos that they can on all platforms. I'll be talking tomorrow about video marketing. Have a good night. Bye.